Hello everyone out there, we want to share an amazing testimony here. We are at a table here at McDonald's in a city in Denmark called Randers. And we, with the pioneer training school we have been sending people out all over Denmark. We had like 70 people being out in 10, 15 different teams all over Denmark. And we have been a team here with different people. Andreas, can you sit down here? Andreas have been here, Josh Ray who are filming is there, and Rasmus and other people. And we just see Josh Ray have been amazing.
It was great. Great trip. Yes, I love it.
You love it?
I love it.
Have been good?
Yes, very good.
And we just want to just explain our testimony, what God has done, because for us this has been mind-blowing how God has led us, the Holy Spirit. We were praying before we left that we'll find a person of peace, Luke chapter 10. We'll be invited to a home and share the gospel. And we have just come from that home now. And we had an amazing time in that home where we came in, but three people got healed, a lot of things happened. But how we were led there is crazy. It starts three days ago, we were drove through this big city in Denmark where there was a shopping mall over there. There, I saw a guy walk like this and looked down and I felt I needed to stop him. I went to him, but he didn't see me. He just looked down and continued. So Andrea said, okay, let's go to McDonald's. So we went to McDonald's and there outside the car, when we parked, that same guy came again, and then of course I knew this is really God. I run out, I stop him, I get word of knowledge for him, he get healed in the back, he's really amazed. I talk with him, I say, where are you going? And he said, I'm going to McDonald's to meet my friends, can we join? Yes. So we met that first guy here, we saw him one place and then we saw him another place, and he led us into McDonald's to this table we are sitting at now. When we came to this table, there was five young people here at the table. We ended up praying for two who got healed, and one really experienced the Holy Spirit. And we had a strong, strong time here at McDonald's 3 days ago. Then we jumped in the car, we went another place where we should, and we went a place 1 hour from here, where we met a girl who had got baptized with the Holy Spirit a week ago at a kickstart. We want to follow up on her. We came there at her school. We were at her school, like a boarding cost school. We came to her school. We had a meeting in her school and I was going to meet people. And suddenly I heard somebody said, oh, there is some Christian meetings, let's go. So there was a girl who knew there was a Christian meeting. So she wanted to go. So I stopped her, said, hey, don't go. Why do you want to go? And I talked with her about God and I ended up praying for her and she got healed and she was very open now, so we sat down and shared the gospel. With her and many others, we went to another room and shared the gospel and people just met God. We prayed for a girl who fell down, received the Holy Spirit, a Christian, received the Holy Spirit, spoke in tongues. We prayed for a few who got healed and there was especially one guy. What happened with him?
It was so amazing because he saw what happened and he had such serious questions. So me and him were sitting in the back of the room, and when he started to ask this question, I just knew directly, this is a person of peace from Luke chapter 10. You can read about a person of peace. And I just knew I want to speak more with him. I will spend all my time with him because he asked such a question. I just knew he wants more. God is already drawing him, and I just explain him, answer his question. We went down to his room because he had his Latvian Bible there, and I prayed for him, and he received the Holy Spirit. He fell into the floor, and he just saw two hands holding him. And I said, "But was it my hands?" No. It was two hands that held me. And it was just God's hands in his vision. We took him to the ocean, we baptized him, I think 10, 11 o'clock in the total darkness, but it was so beautiful.
Yeah. I have a picture here where you can see the baptism. It's good I had a light so we could light out there where you can see the baptism, but that guy, he repented, he received the Holy Spirit, spoken tongues, got baptized. And we had a really beautiful day that day. It ended up that when we came there, suddenly I got a text message from a girl who wrote to me, "Hi Torben, I came to McDonald's short time ago and I'm amazed what happened. So what happened and then can we meet?" It was actually a girl who, after we were McDonald's and we left this place, this table, we left this place, table, 10 minutes later, there came one of their friends in. And she came in and she heard them, they were in shock. They were talking about everything that was happening and she heard it all. And she was so amazed with what she heard and how her friends got healed. So she actually wrote to me when we were at the other place, I really want to meet you, I want to hear about God, can you come, can we meet? Then I became friends with her on Facebook, plus the girl I met. And what happened? There we found out that they were old neighbors. That girl we met in another city was old neighbors to the house we had just been in. So it's so amazing how God just put things together. The day after, we were back there, but we experienced a lot of persecution. That is also the things, and people started to warn against us and persecution. So it was a little difficult the day after. But still a lot of things happened. We were in a house, we stayed in where we had our prayer yesterday, where the woman fell down and got set free. Something left her, it just came out of her and spoke strong in tongues. And you can see the picture here. And it was really beautiful also. But then today we were supposed to meet with that girl who came to McDonald's 10 minutes after we were at this table. And we were supposed to meet with her father and uncle and her friend and her mother and so on. But we came there today, but some of them didn't come, but some was there. She was there and her father was there and her uncle. What was interesting is that we had a friend with us who had come to Christ 6 years ago. We had stayed with the guy we stayed in his house. He was with us today. As soon as we stepped into that house, they were just in shock because the house we were in was his old friend. He had gone in school with, he had been drinking with, he had been partying with. So just there, everything was so organized from the beginning. And in that house, we shared the gospel. We had been there 3 hours, shared the gospel. She got healed for something in her legs. The father, he got healed in the hip. The uncle, he had problem in the arm after an accident and he got healed. And we shared the gospel. And they were really sweet people, really nice. And we got contact with them. They're not ready, have repented now and got baptized because they were not there yet. But they have really moved a lot the last 3 hours and we are in contact with them now. They're really amazing people. But for us, it's been really, really strong to see how the Holy Spirit leads. Try to see the big picture. We prayed, we felt, let's go to a mall. What happened that mall? We met one guy in the mall. But then we went to McDonald's, we met the same guy. He took us to this table. In this table, people met God and got healed. 10 minutes later, after we left this room, a girl came in and was amazed. And she was that person of peace we were looking for. We went to another city, 1 hour from there, and meet her neighbor. And we did a video where we greet her, and that just opened her up also, that she actually saw her neighbor there. And it was so special. And then we went to her house with another guy, who was actually the friend of the father. And they were just ready to receive and listen to what we have to say. So I just want to say for us, it's really been encouragement to see how the Holy Spirit has brought everything together and how we, not by accident, it's not coincidence, it's by the leading of the Holy Spirit, can meet people who are organized from creation on to meet each other. And it has been an amazing trip. So we just, what will you say? All in all,
yeah, it was really amazing to see how we were led to a place and to another and to another person. For me, it was really strong to go in that school, and we ended up being in a room with so many young people, many come, and we could share. I could actually share the gospel with them, and they were all really listening. And you see, and one of them was so touched that he actually understood the gospel and got baptized the same night. But yeah, for me, that was so strong, how God opened the door in place you would not thought. So and when you see the big picture after 3 days, you just realize how everything fit together. When you're in the middle of it, you don't realize it so much. But then after this 3 days, you look back and you're like, wow, there is only God who can orchestrate all of this, organize all of this.
And you are ready to do it again?
Yes, I want to learn more how to be led by the Spirit, yeah.
Rasmus there was with us. We met actually another guy also who got baptized, and Rasmus was there baptizing him also. How was it, Rasmus?
It was an amazing experience and try it for the first time, and it was good to try.
Andreas, do you want to say something then?
I think when we summarize everything now, I'm just thinking, why did this happen? And it happened because we stepped out. 2 days ago, 3 days ago, we were in our home, but we took a step out in faith. I'm not a super evangelist, but I want to do it. I want to do this for people out there. And this is what happened. This was only 3 days out, and it will follow me all my life, all these testimonies.
And for me, it was eye-opening, also as a team, because we are a very different team. But Rasmus, there was a man who came, and Rasmus sat down with him, took good time to share the gospel with him, and he got baptized while we could sit in another room and share there. And at the school, he took one in the room downstairs. And it's so good to be a team and be out there. And as I said, it's going to follow us. It's going. Yeah. There have been an eye opener. There have been a really an experience of like how the Holy Spirit can lead and follow up on and put people together. And it's not finished here, because we want to follow up on people.
Yeah.
We want to now send apostolic teams to those people, because we are not the only one who have been out. Many, many people have been out, and we know of, I don't know, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10 people got baptized just the last 2 days, what I heard about, many. And we want to follow up on them by sending out teams, because now we want to meet again, we want to meet their friends, we want to meet their neighbors, we want to set up a house fellowship, we want to build them up to become strong disciples, from babies to young ones to strong disciples. So this is our heart. And today was just, the last days have just been a small step. So now we are going to go home. And remember, we can do this every day. That is the mind-blowing thing, that we don't need to have our arranged Kickstart weekend. We don't need to go to another country. This is in Denmark where I live. We can just do it.
Last word.
Amen. Glory to God.
Glory to God.
That's good.
Yeah. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.